quite some time now, there's been a phenomenon happening here in Tobago. It's called the sargassum seaweed about the place. And today we're in Speyside. I'm going to give you an idea as to how this looks like right now. And there you go. That's the little Tobago in the background behind there. And the entire bay is inundated with the sargassum seaweed. Now a lot of people have been, taking pictures and videos of this from on the surface. But today, yesterday, we are going to give you a different perspective. We're going to go underneath the seaweed. Yeah, we don't do things normal, we do things differently. So today, we're going to give you a look as to what this looks like from beneath. Take a look one more time. That's little Tobago outside here. Goat Island, little Tobago in the background. And the entire of Tyrrell's Bay or Tyrrell's Bay is covered with sargassum seaweed. Water, I don't know what is a tragedy. Africa nature. We see you on the other side. Sargassum is approximately 6 to 7 feet deep. When you look at how high this is right here, and this is supposed to be on the surface of the water. I mean, this is just something else. Crazy. Right, folks, it's your boy Dave here. Good shot done, buddy Antonio. Right?
Come on. Right.
What we're doing is that there's been this, you know, this invasion of sargassum in the space area. A lot of people have been taking pictures, you know, of what it looks like in different areas, on the hill and the beach and the bay and the jetty. But we're going to give you the underwater perspective. Yeah. It takes them a different level. So, right back as we go in the water. As we entered the water, what was noticeable was how warm it was on a sunny Sunday morning. Immediately the sun shone through the sargassum, and the many fish that were in the water greeted us. We didn't know if they were welcoming us or they were asking us for help. What we did also observe that is that within the sargassum, the small fish seemed to be gathered there. They were either feeding or searching for more light. Not only in one area, but they seemed to be gathered in different areas throughout the sargassum on the surface of the water. The fish came from all over. Even my dive buddy Antonio seemed to be amazed that all his fish seemed to be approaching us from all angles. As if to say, help us, we need our sunlight. Above us, the sargassum was so thick that our bubbles seemed to be making holes within the sargassum for light to come through. What I didn't anticipate was how dark it would be. As we went further to shore, we had to turn our light on because there was nothing we could see inside there. Whilst diving, the sargassum began to get thicker. So thick that it was almost impossible to swim within it. Occasionally, maybe as a wave would roll, the light would pair through from the top, allowing us to get bits of visual. Meanwhile, on the seafloor, the area is very sandy. What was noticeable was the absence of the normal algae-eating fish that we know. The parrotfish, the angelfish, the surgeonfish, trumpetfish, and all the other smaller versions, the damselfish and such like. There were no sight of these species of fish. Our light seemed to be fighting to shine through the dark. We had no idea what we were going to come upon. For direction, we had to use our underwater compass. That's how we know which direction we were going. Not only on the surface was there sargassum, the entire seafloor was also carpeted with the weed. Amongst it, the occasional crab, maybe a sea cucumber, but not much life underneath there. A mixture of sand, silt, and sargassum carpeted the entire floor. So not only on the surface is the sargassum, but also on the seafloor. The entire seafloor is carpeted with the weed. After being unable to see where we were going, we decided to head back where more light was available for our cameras. And the fish seemed to be swimming around in amazement as to help us. You know, they just seemed to be swimming around. I had to take off my hat because the seaweed was all over it. It was making it uncomfortable, all in my face. I had to remove my hat. I normally swim in a hat. this species of fish, apparently they were either looking for stuff to feed on, but it was in abundance all over. Where we were was not as thick and heavy as in Tyrrell's Bay in Speyside on the beach. We were in Bateau Bay, closer to Blue Waters Inn. Heaven only knows how bad it is in the other areas. We decided to head back towards the jetty where we came. In certain areas, it was really thick. And we were uncertain if we could ever dive in that area. From the surface, it looks bad. But could you imagine if you were a fish? Wake up one morning and there was no morning to greet you. Finally, the jetty was in sight. And we were able to resurface once again.